The next game that we're going to play is called Three-Headed Expert. This is my expert right here, and he has three heads. Can I please be told what he is an expert in?
Tiger Woods.
Tiger Woods? An expert in Tiger Woods. An expert in Tiger Woods. Oh, thank you so much. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Golfing For You. My name is Linda Matterhorn, and I actually am really excited to introduce to you right now an expert in Tiger Woods. Could you introduce yourself, the expert in Tiger Woods?
My name
is
Hugo Goster
the Third.
Oh, that is an impressive name, Hugo Goster the Third.
Thank you,
Sarah.
Oh, he's calling me by my middle name. Okay, all right. So. Oh, yes, please. Bring some water. Wow. Being an expert in Tiger Woods makes one thirsty.
It does.
Certainly.
So tell me, what got you interested in learning all about Mr. Woods?
My mama
taught
me to
golf.
But
I
never
really
thought
I
was
good
enough.
Oh. Well, so you got over that and became an expert then in someone else.
I think
I
like to
watch.
Oh, it is a wonderful spectator sport. So, do you have any critique over Mr. Woods' game playing?
I find
his
swing too
far,
too soon,
too
early.
I would be sorely remiss if I did not bring up a little bit of the tragedy that has befallen the Mr. Woods family household.
Don't like
talking
about
the
tragedy
because
it
is
deeply
intense.
Yes, that is true. That is true. I think we can all agree that it has been a most intense thing. If you were, let's say Mr. Woods were to call you up. And
he did
call
me
up
the
other day.
And
he said,
"Hello,
Hugo, how
are
you doing?"
I
said,
"Well,
I'm
pretty
hungry."
And
then
I
had
a
piece
of
butter.
Bill, that sounds delicious. So it sounds like you have a close relationship with Mr. Woods, a friendship, if you would.
We are
his
soulmate.
Do you think that perhaps you had anything to do with the breaking up of Mr. Tiger Woods' household?
Yes, I
did.
I found
out
the
end.
Sorted.
Of
ring
details.
Are you telling me that you could or could not have possibly have had a liaison with Mr. Woods on my show?
I did
have
a
liaison.
Oh! This is most exciting. This may be the biggest bombshell of information ever on my show on Golfing For You. Please tell us more about your liaison with Mr. Woods.
I find
him
so
very
attractive.
Oh. Well, I think many of our viewers would agree with you on that. He's most attractive. Tell me, and this is coming from as a fan, do you by any chance know any of his personal likes or interests?
He
likes
Johnny Cash.
Oh. Well, as you know, because of the unfortunate incident of the past few months, people have been very much against Mr. Woods, almost to the point of saying that he should just drop out of society altogether. What do you have to say to these people?
I find
him
so remarkable
and
beautiful
that
he
must stay
on
this planet.
Definitely.
Okay.
And he
must
not
go
south.
That is absolutely extraordinary, and I do hope that Mr. Woods is at home golfing for you. Say something to Mr. Woods, because I do believe he does watch my program.
Tiger.
Wood.
You.
Marry.
Me?
Please.
There's a ring, Tiger. A ring! Well, that has been an exciting episode of Golfing For You. Please tune in next week when we can possibly have an answer from Mr. Woods. Say something to our viewers, please.
Good night.
He's number one, she's number two, you're number three, and I'm number four.
You're the heavy still. That won't stop me.
Call you Mike.
You make a dead man come.
You've been talking in too long.
I have.
And I thought they smelled bad on the inside.
I'm aware, but we can make it work. It
smells much worse when it comes out.
I agree, but I think you and I...
Probably lunch.
Ghost! Did you see it?
This is not an open primary. Only party candidates.
Hurry up.
Oh, that's the ghost of campaign past.
Oh my God.
Last week I had a colonoscopy. I'm glad it's behind me. They say jokes diffuse tension in scary, like, possession situations.
I feel it coming closer.
It's coming closer? That's sort of like a colonoscopy.
I haven't had one yet.
Senator Tom. It's me, Jude Law.
What?
He's talking to you now.
Jude?
I see you creeping around behind my back.
Jude, but someone looks like...
I'm beautiful!
You are so beautiful.
Call him mine.
Smile! Don't you know God loves you? It's okay, Jude! We're both here, you can have us both!
Jude, mine!
Jude? Jude?
Without integrity, nothing works!
That's exactly what I've been saying! We can smile! The three of us!
The three of us?
We can completely make one!
Sam, line!
Oh my.
Unconditional love is doing your part no matter what the other person does!
That's what I've been saying this whole time!
You're right!
Your arguments have convinced me! Brief as they are and pithy!
We can embrace it! Take it upon us and take it to the world.
Call in line!
It's hard being tall in a small world, but I am prepared for the challenge.
Tell me about it, sister.
Jude, you know who's tall? Jude Law is tall.
Jude Line.
I clean my house all day like I'm on meth.
We can actually use that.
Because I have integrity.
It's true.
Integrity and love and the hype. We can take this everywhere and we will rule the world.
Love, integrity, and math. I mean, metaphorically.
I think we should move on to the next campaign.
The next campaign?
I'm ready.
You're ready?
I'm ready.
I'm ready.
Jude, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Let's do this.
Let's do this. Jude, embrace us.
Jude! Oh, I feel Jude's energy.
Oh, I feel it so close.
Your hair is so wavy.
Oh. He's becoming one with us.
Yay!
Thank you. That's the first half. We're going to take a quick 5-10 minute break, and we'll be right back into a long form, which is a very different sort of thing. But thank you so much for coming to this first part, and we're just going to introduce ourselves really quick. We're Awkward Face. I'm Alan.
Sam.
Colleen.
Jennifer.
David.
Virginia.